Adversity happens. Adversity is part of life. But it's how we incorporate its wisdom that defines us as we move forward. The wisdom allows us to come back stronger and more resilient, creating new dreams rather than mourning lost ones. But adversity's greatest reward is realizing what you're made of. I was raised in Arlington, Massachusetts, the grandson of Armenian immigrants. I was a student of the 60s. That's me behind the hair. I studied mathematics and later got an MBA from the University of Massachusetts in Amherst. During my 21-year run with CSC Index, I consulted to senior executives in large corporations in North America as well as Europe. In my early 30s, I fell in love and married my wife, Gail. Later, we had two wonderful children, Laura and Mark. Our lives were full of happiness and joy. I discovered how life can change in an instant. I'm talking to you from the Boston Medical Center, where I've been for 2 weeks, recovering from a spinal cord disc operation. I had suffered from an unprovoked disc rupture that left me permanently paralyzed from the waist down. I spent 2 months in a rehab hospital learning how to live a very different life. Upon returning home, we faced some major challenges, like how to get into my house. We had to make major modifications to our home so I could get in and around. But there would be other challenges. Simple things like dressing and bathing were difficult tasks. Over time, I settled into a daily routine. I committed myself to try to walk again. Slowly, I learned to stand with braces. After 4 years of weekly physical therapy, I achieved that goal. That milestone prompted me to try skiing again, and then golf. Although not the same as before, it's still an enjoyable experience. After getting involved with the Christopher Reeve Foundation, Gail and I had the opportunity to meet with him. He encouraged me to use my leadership skills as an advocate for others. When I testified before the state legislature in favor of stem cell research, I reminded the senators that medical research offered hope to many and fear to a few. Hope won, and the bill passed. This past year, I shared my story in the Harvard Business Review. It's a simple message to leaders. People won't remember how far you fall, but rather how high you bounce back. I believe that the lessons of leadership are grounded in the wisdom of adversity. That wisdom will shape your future. In my life, I love you more.